And we have team coverage. Christian Garzone is on site right now. We're going to hear more from him a bit later. First, though, let's go to Rebecca Fath, who joins us from downtown Rochester. And Rebecca, we're talking hundreds of jobs here, a company reimagined with a potentially huge economic impact. What have you found out?
Well, Maureen, the businesses that we spoke with today are crossing their fingers that Kodak is successfully able to reinvent itself, especially a job placement center just down the street from here.
At UPrep, young people are trained for manufacturing jobs like the jobs that could soon be available on Kodak's campus.
Many of our students spent the last 2 years doing apprenticeships in some of the big companies in Rochester. So this opportunity that we hope will happen in Rochester with more manufacturing would be a fantastic opportunity for our young people.
The CEO says this is exciting on many levels because they hope to work with Kodak to change training plans so those graduating can be ready to apply right away and stay in Rochester working instead of leaving. And the Greater Rochester Chamber of Commerce is reacting, releasing this statement today. The Greater Rochester Chamber of Commerce is pleased to see a historic local company tapped for a federal manufacturing initiative that will help combat COVID-19 as well as bring 300 jobs to our region. And with this news comes a jump in Kodak's stocks.
An important part of Kodak coming back, if they do come back, will be the growth of local suppliers, both for chemical feedstocks and for the equipment and services that Kodak traditionally bought in our area.
So educators and job placers are optimistic.
We could train our young people to say, here's what is in the community, here's some opportunities, so we could retool them and prepare them for the jobs that are coming.
And Maureen, coming up in the next hour, we're going to visit a restaurant just around the corner from Kodak where they're a little bit more skeptical of this news. We'll explain why. For now, we are live in Rochester. Rebecca Fath, News 8.
All right, Rebecca, thank you. And again, we are following this story closely. For all of the latest updates as they happen, be sure to visit rochesterfirst.com and more team coverage coming.